We have now successfully reached an important goal of IKEA of having all IKEA products in cotton from more sustainable sources. In IKEA, we love working with cotton, but we were uncomfortable with the fact that conventional cotton has lots of negative environmental footprint. Since 2005, IKEA began taking steps to transform the way cotton is grown. IKEA partnered with WWF because we shared the same view on this.
There are 300 million people whose livelihood is attached with this crop, and the farmers are very poor. Cotton is grown in areas which are already water-stressed, where the rivers have already been polluted.
We were convinced that there has to be a better way of growing the cotton.
And IKEA literally asked their suppliers that we want you to use better cotton in the articles that you supply to us.
In the beginning, only 500 farmers joined in our project. But after 1 year, when they saw the results, more and more farmers joined. We have helped more than 110,000 farmers to learn sustainable cotton farming. The farmers can afford better quality of life, including improved health, and sending their children to the schools because of higher gross margin.
IKEA relies on good, long-term relationships with suppliers who share our values and take responsibility. So in 2000, we introduced our code of conduct, IWAY, which specifies our minimum requirements relating to the environment, social impact, and working conditions. And there are social challenges. Child labor is one. And we are constantly working for the many children living in poverty by creating programs that support the families overall and help prevent children from working in cotton factories and fields. Through the IKEA Foundation, we work closely with UNICEF and Save the Children to give millions of children in cotton-growing communities better opportunities in life.
Mala shikun motoon shikshika banaychai.
Cotton supply chain is very long, is very complex. From the farms to the ginning, spinning, weaving, knitting, processing.
The knowledge of the whole supply chain presented us with an even bigger mission, going global.
IKEA and WWF, along with others, helped to set up Better Cotton Initiative, which aims to make global cotton production better for the people who grow it, better for the environment, and better for the sector's future by making better cotton a mainstream commodity.
There are like 300 companies who control the production and the trade. We have to work with these big companies. Around 200 manufacturers, producer organizations, NGOs became members of BCI and started supporting this global initiative.
And our vision for 2020 is that Better Cotton makes up 30% of global cotton production. We'll be working with 5 million farmers worldwide, and we'll bring benefits to more than 20 million people in primary production. We have three key principles. First principle is collaboration. There is no one player that can transform a sector that spans some 80 countries, employing tens of millions of people. The only way of doing it is together with all involved. And the second principle is that we built a system where there is no premium built in that gets passed through the supply chain. Instead, retailer and brands can connect to a system where they are allowed to invest directly at the farm level. The third principle is around being pragmatic and realistic. We have a baseline that is challenging but achievable. And then there are requirements for everyone to get better every year as we move towards full sustainability.
We want to see cotton become sustainable worldwide and not only for our business. Our vision is that sustainable cotton becomes affordable and accessible to all the people in the world. And it's about making those people visible, those who are invisible part of the supply chain. IKEA's vision is to create better everyday life for the many people. And that includes the cotton farmers as well.